Now, the order of operations for blade adjustment is set your tension and your tracking. We've got that done already. The next step is adjusting the guides. Let's bring the guides forward. The first step is to bring the guides forward to where the thrust shaft or the thrust bearing in the back here touches the back of the blade. And you just ever so slightly want to touch the back of the blade with that ceramic. And once that's set, we're going to lock the center post right here in place. What that thrust bearing does is it keeps this blade from wanting to get pushed back when you push the wood into it. Now that that's set, we want to bring the guides forward. Now, the side guides don't want to come over and overlap the teeth. It'll damage the blade and it'll damage the ceramics. What you want to do is to set your ceramics about an eighth of an inch or so behind the gullet or the cutout of the tooth. With that set in that position right there, what we'll do is go ahead and tighten this section of the guides in place. And that's ready to go. Now that we've got the thrust bearing forward and we've got our ceramics behind the gullet of the tooth, we're going to bring the side guides in. And I typically will bring these in and just ever so slightly touch the blade. You don't want to move or deflect the blade at all. You want to come up and just touch the blade with both of those and snug that down. And do that with both sides and simply pull that through. Now that's a nice tight adjustment. If you're a little leery of coming up to the blade there, what some people will do is take a piece of paper and fold it over the blade like this and bring that down and set the side guides up against a piece of paper. That gives you just a little bit of air gap. Really, you don't need to do this on the ceramics, but for some people that are doing this for the first time, it gives them just a little bit of air gap to be comfortable. They'll sit like that, tighten it down, pull the paper out. There's a little bit of a gap right there. That gives you enough operation room. Our top guide is set. You just want to make sure that those are snugged down and that pulls through great. Let's do the bottom guides. Now the bottom guides are the same thing, they're just upside down, and we're going to do that through the tabletop or just by simply reaching through the bottom. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to bring the guides forward and we're going to set that side guide clearance here so that you have the ceramics about an eighth of an inch or so behind the gullet of the tooth. Once those are set and that the guide assembly is pretty much parallel to the blade, I'm going to go ahead and snug those down with the Allen wrench. Now the ball Allen wrench makes this very easy to reach down through the table. What you may want to do is just to crank those down a little bit tighter once they're done. Now that that's set, I'm going to bring the thrust bearing forward to where it just touches the back of the blade. And again, you don't want to push the blade forward, but just barely touches it. Snug that down. Now that we have the guides forward and we have the thrust bearing in place, we're going to simply bring the side guides in. And again, you can come up and just touch the blade ever so slightly. You don't want to move or deflect it. If you want to put a piece of paper in there, you can. Some people will use a piece of paper. Others will use a dollar bill for clearance. If you have blades that are poor quality and they have a bad weld on them, as they go through the ceramics, they might bind a little bit. Now, I like to pull the blade through the saw just to make sure that there's no binding and everything seems to be pretty stable. I like how that's running nice and true through the guides. Now, one note about the ceramic guides is as the blade goes through there, particularly when you're cutting hard, you might see a few sparks. And that happens with ceramic guides. It happens with some of the disc guides as well. The sparks that come off the ceramics are orange and they might catch your eye a little bit. It's normal to see a few of those. You'll typically see it more with a new blade and it seems to diminish a little bit after you run the saw a little bit. But if you see those, it's no cause for concern. You're able to go through and start cutting. Now that our blade is in place, we've got the tension, the tracking, and the guide set, we can simply go back in and reinstall the guards. Let's go ahead and put back in the lower guard. That'll drop right back in. Tighten the thumb screw. The upper guard will slide right back in, just like this. Now, one note about this upper guard is it can kind of move in or out a little bit. Just make sure you have clearance on the door. You might want to bring it out, tighten it by thumb a little bit, and then put your Allen wrench on there. If you need to adjust a little bit just to have it perpendicular with the saw, you can do that. There's enough play on here to be able to go through and adjust it to where that's out of the way of the door and it clears the wheel. So we've got the upper guard on, we've got the lower guard on. Now we can take our throat plate and reinstall it, turn the catch sideways, drop it in place, reach around the bottom, use the spring-loaded catch to lock it into the table. The last step is our lock knob. That'll slide right in the groove on the side. That's in the side here. We'll go ahead and get that snug down, and we're about ready to go. Now we've got our tension, our tracking, and our guide set. We want to make sure that the table is 90 degrees to the blade. Let's go ahead and check this right now. And you can see on the bottom here that we're off a little bit. We have a little bit of a gap. And that just means that we need to adjust it 90 degrees to the blade. In order to do that, let's go around the back to the positive stop. Back off the lock nut and take your wrench and watch your square as you adjust the nut here. And that's right about on. I'm going to go ahead and lock it back in place, and we're ready to go. All right, the bandsaw is almost set up and ready to run. We've got the tension, the tracking, the guides adjusted. We've got the table adjusted 90 degrees to the blade. The only thing that we have left to do in terms of adjustments is to adjust the fence, and we want to adjust the fence so that it's parallel to the blade. And that's called setting the drift adjustment. Before we do that, though, we want to get the saw ready to use. It's a good time to take off the last little minute details here, and also to hook up a dust collection system. If you have a single port on the dust collection, you can bring it right here to the top. If you have two ports, hook one to the top and one to the back, and that'll give you the best dust extraction possible. Let's step around. We're going to get the saw set up to go through and set the drift adjustment. Now, setting the drift angle on the fence basically means that we're going to set the fence up parallel to the blade. Not just the blade itself, though, but to the dynamic way that the blade is cut. And so in order for us to set that, we'll take a piece of scrap wood and put it through the saw. Now, typically, you're going to set the drift adjustment when you're doing resaw work and you have a little wider blade on there. We can do it with a half-inch blade. If you're doing curves and circles, you're not using the fence for those operations, and you don't need to set that adjustment. So in order for us to set this, let's go ahead and put on the safety glasses. Let's drop the guides down very close to our workpiece so that we're working safe. And let's go ahead and just make a cut with a piece of wood up against the fence and see where it aligns in the cut. Now we've made the first cut, and we've stopped the saw with the blade still in the kerf, or the cut of the wood. And the first thing that I notice here is that this gap on this side of the blade is pretty wide, and the gap on this side is almost non-existent. That means that the back edge of the blade is running against the side of the wood, and that lets me know that my fence is angled this way ever so slightly. What we'll do is just take our wrench, our Allen wrench, loosen the fence, and move the blade out this way, and that'll set our drift adjustment. Once we do that, we'll take another cut and make sure it's right on. Now, in order to set the drift adjustment, I find that it's easiest to reach the nuts and bolts on the bottom just by simply laying the fence over, loosening it with the Allen wrench. And I typically just loosen one. You can loosen them both, but then it moves around quite a bit. With that loosened, I'll simply just tap it over a little bit and snug that down. And there's not a lot of movement required there because we were pretty close. If you're off a little bit, you may find that you have to move that just a bit. Now what I'll do is I'll take another cut and see if we're centered. I'll shut off the bandsaw, and I'm going to have a look here at the cut. And I notice that the blade is fairly well centered in the cut. I've got a gap on both sides, and that lets me know that we're ready to go. Now, the closer you have to an even gap, you're better off. If you have just a little more on one side than the other side, that's okay. You just want to make sure that you have an air gap so that wood isn't moving and steering the blade at all. That pretty much covers the setup and the adjustment of the bandsaw. We've got the fence set. I went ahead and tightened the screw on the bottom side to make sure that it's locked in place. If you'd like to set this a little bit easier, there is an option of installing our Driftmaster fence system, and that simply adjusts this fence with a tool-free change, and it lets you dial it in with a hand wheel. It's an option on the saw. If you want to step up and go to that, you can, but now we've shown you how to do it with the standard fence. Now that we've got the saw ready to go, let's go ahead and take some pieces of wood. I like to start off with some scrap wood and go through it and start making a few test cuts to see how it performs.